I think I can throw over to this screen without any worries. So this is the wheel as it stands today, right? And you notice that we have three, Tom's Barrow, the bottom one, perfect. This is probably as close as I'll get. So we have three things that we hit last time. We have this Yoda Stories that we got, this Save Sophia percent, which turned out to be a pretty spicy run. That was fun. And then this Crunch percent, which I've I have adapted from what Oz's original entry, which I hope that people have enjoyed the Bonnie posts. I think I owe one more for today. But there's been basically a post every single day of Bonnie. And I know Meows has jumped in a few times at this point with some extra bonus content. So if you're looking for your Bon tent, the Discord has been where to go recently. But anyways, we hit these three spots on the last section here. Let me just make sure that these have been ported over. Yeah, we're good. Okay, cool. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stand by. Hang on. Helps if I have editing enabled. I'm gonna go ahead and just delete and shift up. Delete and shift up. So what's a spin Sunday without doing some admin work? Cool, so we gotta add three new things on here from the wheel pool. So today's additions are as such. We got this one added recently. Well, I should say not this one, but this series was on the wheel recently for the first time in a long time. And I had a lot of fun with it. And I was like, I want to do it again. So, yeah, we're going to do it again. Conveniently, this was added by Electric Dragon recently. This is a Ben Jordan 3 any percent. We're going to pop that one on there. Ben Jordan 3 is actually a really cool speed run. So, you know, we were talking about maybe the slight differences between... you know, any percent and 100%. And it's like, you know, in Ben Jordan 6, which is the one we were playing last time, there are differences. There's a couple, there are definitely extra things we need to do, but the only real route, like big route change that has to happen is right in the middle of the boat section. There needs to be basically a drop back to do a couple things and then you come back. The rest of it's mostly the same kind of path, but like, you know, with extra doodads on the side. Ben Jordan 3, on the other hand, is probably the most interesting run of all of them. Maybe Ben Jordan 8 is probably the other one, where the any percent run and the 100% run are vastly different to each other. So Ben Jordan 3 actually has a completely different ending for any percent than it does for 100%. Which is really cool. I don't know. My the reason I go into this is because it's very neat, and I'm excited to do some Ben Jordan 3 running. Also, Ben Jordan 3 rules, and I think this is actually an important game, kind of historically, because this is sort of the last game I think that exists in like Grundyslav's portfolio. As far as Ben Jordan goes, of kind of looking like an classic old school AGS game. And I mean that as a compliment in that like everything that like, if you take a look at like Lamplight City or, you know, if you've seen anything about Rosewater, and then you'll see Ben Jordan 3, like the growth is insane. And there's something like warm and fuzzy about Ben Jordan 3 because it's the last game that like Ben Jordan 1 and Ben Jordan 2 were remastered and they were kind of done up with more modern style graphics closer to like Ben Jordan 7 and 8, you know, when that series kind of was, you know, at its peak in terms of of the tech side of things. This, like, this has just been Jordan 3 straight up. I don't know. I'll talk about it more if we hit it, but it is a very, very cool video game, and I love it. I really do love it. So thank you for the submission there, Electric Dragon. All right, not to be outdone by excellent video games. I realize that I think I've said this a bunch of times on stream where I'm like, oh, you know what? I need to do another run of this. I never did it. Another day goes by. Oh, I got to do a run of that. You know what? I got to do a run of that. So let's make sure we keep to our word here. A little Broken Sword. We have not run back Broken Sword 1, I think, since it was initially on the wheel many moons ago at this point. So Stripes has put an 80% run in there. So, yeah, we'll do a little Broken Sword, a little George Stobart action for you and yours. Yeah, Carpets, yes. Hello, Stripes. Perfect, yeah. To round this thing off today is a category of a game that I have never run before. And if we do hit this, I'm probably going to have to watch a run. We'll do a little VOD review because I don't actually know what the 100% run will look like. Now, this seems like a bad idea, right? Like 100% runs are typically like hours long for many games. I think there's only 7 points to get in this game. You might know what I'm getting at, but Santa had a while back put in a run for Owl's Quest 100%. So yeah, we're going to collect all of the points in Owl's Quest at some point. So that's the 3 new additions to the wheel. Hope you're excited. I am very excited to run through these. And of course, the you know, the wall is quite good here. We've got a very good wheel, you know, inherited a good wheel at large here. So should be fun. Owl's Quest, let's go. I don't know. It's an interesting one. So let me just get a quick copy there, and then I'll rebuild the wheel once more. And then we'll get into the runs proper for the day. Okay, I think we're set. Let's pause the music because I think this is about to go off. Yeah, here we go. Shouts out to Frozen Spade who wrote the music here. As always, it's a banger. Chat back into a more comfortable spot. Message in a haunted mansion getting hit. Very good. Yeah, and that is what will happen. If we do hit something that's a first play, we'll squeeze in as much as we can, and that'll be the Sunday until it's not the Sunday anymore, which should be pretty cool. I'm excited for that game. I think it'll be cool. It seems like a lot of people want me to play it, so I think that'll be neat. All right. Hey, Omesta. Thanks for the good luck. I appreciate it. Keep that streak alive. Let's spin. Let's do it. What do we have? Ooh, the Puggsy. A little bit of Puggsy. Okay, sure. How am I gonna play Puggsy with this set? Okay, yeah, it's fine. We'll figure this out. Gonna hook up the old Sega Genesis here. Let's flip that to yes. A little Puggsy. Puggsy rules. If you've never played Puggsy before, it is a platformer that was on the Sega, but it's also basically a puzzle game as well. You kind of collect and use items on things, and also there's kind of like this wild physics situation. I always wanted to run the any percent, like learn and run the any percent category for this, but the game is insanely deep, and it's not something that you can learn in a day, basically. But what we can do is we can play through this junior percent, which I generally know the speed run of. We're gonna do a few runs if it's quite short, so we'll be able to do a few, but it's a really cool game, and I'll kind of try to talk through it a little bit. But the best part about Puggsy, other than that it looks ridiculous, which we all love, but the soundtrack is absolute fire. It's extremely, extremely good. So anyways, let me throw you all to the BRB screen. And I say that because I need to get a cable to hook up my controller to everything. So hang tight, leave you with some tunes. Be right back. Should be very interesting. I think this will work. So I ran some cables not that long ago, basically to kind of clean my setup up a little bit. And one thing I didn't account for was playing games on the controller, but also on my PC. So that it's going to be a little bit interesting to see how this shakes out. Let's switch over to Puggsy. Don't do that. That's so weird. My Steam just started downloading an update for Disco Elysium. I was like, don't do that. Don't do that. Do that, please. Okay. I think we might be getting close here. There's probably going to be more admin work that we need to do because I'm going to run this through RetroArch. I believe. Thank you. Okay. So I know you can hear it. I can very much see that it's not picking anything up yet. We're gonna fix that. Thank you, Krelos, yeah. Gotta go for the full experience here. Okay, cool. I see it there. Let's see if we can get this thing all tidied up here. So it's gonna be very interesting, actually, to make sure that we... it's gonna be in a little bit of a smaller... Yeah, that's fine. We'll make it work. This is going to be interesting. Oops. There's two different versions of this game. There's a US Japan release and a PAL release, and they have different junior modes. So, we'll have to see how this goes. We need splits as well. This looks like the right one, though. Is this going to ask for that? Yes, it is. Okay. All right, people. Shall we try? The first one might not be crazy fast, but we'll do it for a little bit. We'll do a few runs. Try to get it done. The Starfall Lake 2 level is the one that I tend to struggle with, if I recall correctly. Okay, here we go. Let's begin. I think this might be the wrong one now. Let's see. Maybe not. Okay, we gotta head down. Oh, no, we're good. We're cooking. We're cooking with gas here. So this is Puggsy, by the way. We are Puggsy. And we are, hugging along. So in this speedrun, all we're doing is trying to get to the exit area. But it's really important to sometimes you need to pick up items to be able to get through things. Oh boy, we are dying. This one hasn't been too bad, though. This is the cave, I think, like the mine. Yeah, okay. So unlike some games that you may have played, say like a Mario Brother or something like that, just jumping on top of a bad guy is not enough to kill it. You actually need to hit down at a perfect time to attack the enemy from the top. Oh, geez. So, for instance, you might see that Puggsy sometimes is like, kind of like shimmering. That means that we're attacking. If we're not shimmering, how does this work? This is the tricky one here. If we're not shimmering, we will die. Okay, so we need to pick this candle up. But before we do that, we actually need to go here. So this is again a puzzle. And Junior Percent's kind of like a, you know, kind of just an introduction. So we need to light that giant candle there. So we put the coin in that thing to allow us to turn the burner on. And now we somehow... No. We need to use this candle here to light the big candle. It's always easier... Oh, geez, than you think. And grabbing onto different items is quite difficult. There we go. Boom. And so by lighting the candle, we're able to move into our last area here. So this is actually a boss. As you can tell, the last sort of level here. So we're shooting plungers at this guy, and that's time there. Didn't hit ourselves, which is great. But yeah, this is effectively like the demo mode. So we'll take it. All right, so it was a little slow. 324. A little bit behind what we'd like. But we can always run it again. It's only 3 minutes long, so we can get a bunch of runs in our kind of window here. Yip is a rockin'. Yeah, that's one of the bosses, I think, in the first couple of levels of the full game, where you have to deal with that. I think it's like a bird on a ship or whatever. Check out these graphics, though, right? It's like kind of pseudo 3D graphics. It's pretty good for a Sega. This is like Master Drive, Genesis, you know, Sega. It's pretty good. And again, the soundtrack is just absurd. It's so good. Hey, Archie. Yeah, this game is a trip. Thank you for the good luck. Nice to have you here. Thanks for the GGs. An overstretched JPEG, that's right. What are our options, I wonder? Control? Oh, we can change our controls here. Pick up and drop. Oh, we can add lives. Well, that's cool. I don't think any of these things are probably legal. Although I don't know if anybody cares about Junior Percent. Here we go. Let's do it again. So jumping is faster. I don't know if anybody noticed that. Like, if you move and jump, it's quite a long ways faster than doing it the other way. Kind of just walking. So we're always going to try to be going here. There's some cool tricks, actually, that you can do. Where you can actually, like, fling yourself around. If you, like, hold a, oh, wow, I just died immediately. Very good. Oh, maybe this is the way to go. I never considered having invincibility. Why didn't I ever grab invincibility in the beginning? What? Oh, banger alert. Hang on. I don't know if we're going to be able to get into that anyway. This one's a little bit tough because obviously you've got lots of moving pieces. Oh, I thought I had that one. Ah! Is there one more guy down here? Yep. Big bop. Okay, that's good. We're saving time on two of the splits so far. That's pretty good for us. Okay, so I think going left is the way to go first now that we kind of remember. Oh, but don't drop the coin. That is going to be really bad. Yeah, so we want to go left, jump over. We go here. Oh, look at that. Perfect throw. Got him. So the annoying part is you can actually hurt yourself. That's time. With those plungers as well. Okay, much better than last run. Much, much, much better. Let us go again. We got a hot hand now. We'll definitely grab that invincibility at the top of Starfall Lake too. I think the super hard, like, kind of way to go about that particular, that one there is to actually grab one of the items and then fling yourself up. So this is the water one again, yes? Oh, I just threw it at him. Okay. How do I just use it? Okay. Okay, interesting. I guess there's a different button for just use item, I guess. That guy is not gonna work. Yeah. That one comes in real hot. Nice little bop over the top. Excellent. Little gold. Okay. Very good. Alright, let's not mess the coin thing up here. Been just short. Oh, wow. Let's go. That was actually a really good run. Let me check the controls here, because the one thing I need to double check and like make sure that I'm doing this correctly. It's like, how did I used the invincibility there. And I don't know what I did to do that, because when I tried doing it again, oh, A is use. Okay. A is use, which means, okay, okay. Okay, cool. Let's do it again. I wonder if we can get a PB on this thing. I would be really stoked if that's the case. Puggsy? Like, the thing I'm trying to figure out is, like, what is Puggsy? Oh, wait, did I just do the same level again? Did. Uh-oh, okay. Let's get a reset here. How do I reset with this thing? Just enjoy the jams here quick. Thank you. Like one of these buttons will work. Some theme hospital vibes. Oh yeah. You know who's playing theme hospital recently? In fact, I think today, earlier today. It was either today or yesterday, I can't remember. But Amiga Runs, aka Milktoast, was doing some theme hospital speed runs. And that was pretty cool to see. Okay, let's do another run. It made me want to do some more 2-point hospital runs. Okay, we definitely moved down. There we go. Okay, we're good. Oh, macaw, yeah. Ooh, got away with that one. Let's go. Okay, so this is where we need to use A. So I guess my controller is not mapped to like... So I'm using a Nintendo Switch Pro controller. Oh my goodness. Alright, juked. So it's not like, you know, I'm not using a Sega, like, Genesis controller or anything. So what it's telling me A is might actually be like... Might be X or something. Oh boy! Oh goodness. Big one. Okay, no missing that one. Ooh. Just trying to get the flick there. So picky, the way that that one works. Let's go though, we got it. Go and go. Time. Oh, I'm gonna end up killing myself, even though we already won. That was a gold plunger. Let's go. That port is so bad. I can't say I've ever seen the PSX one. Games like that, I always really struggle to sort of like wrap my head around how it's gonna work using a controller. Like, I feel like games like that lend themselves to mouse and keyboard so well. But I don't know, sometimes that can work, I guess. Level one on a demo disc. Oh, the PSX mouse. Let's go. Yeah, yeah. Amazing. All right, that was a pretty good run there. We kept that one very honest. By far the best of the day so far. If I go here and go to latest run. Yeah, so that's against the last run that we did. Just my change comparison. Here we go. Way better than average. All right, let's begin. I always get such a bad start. Let's see if I can do this thing here. So you can kind of hear, like, see this big jump here that I just got, like that. So you can kind of like if you watch, you know, some other folks do runs of this. There's like a, Yeah, you can do stuff like that. And it moves you on to do things. I don't even know if that's an intended mechanic by the game, but it's just a weird thing. Let's get a restart there. Since I took a weird bounce, I was like, I figured I'd show that off. But that's like a key part of the speedrun and stuff. Kind of jumping around and getting those done. Yeah, at some point I do need to play that Broken Sword. The Game Boy Advance one just, like, kind of, interests me as well. Alright, so I think it is X. I think that's the button that we want to hit here. Okay. I thought I would be able to do that again, but apparently not.
Water physics, why?
Yeah, the Game Boy Advance one I just find to be kind of interesting. I've never played a Broken Sword. Could you imagine? After I added it to the wheel today as well, that would be pretty... Goodness, we're about out of lives here. Let's not mess up anymore. Oh no. Oh shoot. Okay, whatever. We'll get some extra practice on this one. I'll finish this run. We were like on route to the next level, but I guess if you hit start before Puggsy reaches the overworld map. Oh, hello. It must just be like, absolutely not, it's not gonna work. That actually worked out nicely though. Hey Santa, thanks very much. Let's see if we can get a nice clean one of these. Nope. Oh, you can jump on the top of the stick like that, too. I didn't know that. Okay. So we had a mistake, obviously, in there, but that was, there were some positives hidden away as well. Hitboxes are jacked. They really are. This game, it's very odd. I don't even fully understand everything in it quite yet. Like, there is, I don't know. It's like this was made, like, somebody pitched, like, a physics puzzle game, and then they were like, it needs to also be a platformer, though. And then it became a platformer with enemies, like, afterwards. Like, this is the demo, like, you know, demo mode here. Like, you get a gun to get rid of things. What is this? Or you can, like, look and see where things are. It's just kind of an interesting game. Someday maybe I'll learn the rest of the run, but for now, another one. Hey, Reinen, welcome. Welcome to the beach. instincts. Otherwise, it was a very clean run there. You have to, like, hit the one little, the little switch to be able to sort of... Oop, I got stuck. Let's just take the... We're armed. Get out of the way. Now that I know how to use the weapons, I feel like I forgot that. Oh, okay. That's annoying. Like, slipped right in between. That one we were glowing, that's too bad. Rough, but we'll take it. I think this still has a shot to be one of the best of the day, depending on how we handle this level. What you're saying. Very good. Okay. Cool. Okay, it was a delayed, it was like a late final split there. I like that you finished the demo and it's just like, now play the real game. I think we can do a couple more runs here, and we'll do another spin. I love me some Puggsy, though, I'll tell you what. Oop, that's a double split there. There we go. That would have been nice. Take 14 seconds if I can get one. Got it. Okay, good. That is what we wanted to see. Good. Okay. Good. Good. We got stuck on the wall with our item. Not ideal. Ooh, okay, good. Made it over the top. That's ideal. Good jump. Oh, are you kidding me? I think we had clearance there. I think we had clearance. I think that's trash. Truly bad news bears on that one. That bear was bad news. Oh, we got it. Oh, wait, I don't need that anymore. I was like gonna go run after the thing. Good. We are good. Okay. This could be best of the day right here for sure. Oh. Uh-oh. This is not good. Okay. I was in the right again. Okay. That was really, really close to best of the day. I was almost being a little bit too precise at the end. Yeah, trust the plungers. The plungers will find their way there if you let them. believe in the plungers, people. Okay, let's see. Last one, I guess. Let's go. Oh, not this one. This one won't count, though. It's weird because timing starts when you select the difficulty here, and then you immediately have to enter the level as if you're starting the game again. It opens to the map first. We got there, right? No. Okay. I'm gonna be a little ticky-tacky since this is the last one. I have to make sure Puggsy makes it to the location. I don't really love that the game decides like, oh no, you weren't all the way there, so we'll just load you into the last level, which you're actually for sure further away from now. Okay, we're in.
We're in.
Puggsy the hacker here. Uh-oh. Oh, we got it back. We got it back. Okay, we do not have any time for this nonsense here. Okay. Okay, this is a big one here. Gotta make sure we're getting ready here. Oop. We have clearance.
Oh!
That one comes in hot, though. Bear got, revenge. We got revenge on the bear. I mean, maybe we can get something still here, though. This is good. I think that's pretty good.
Oh no!
Uh-oh. Oh, that was probably real good. Fine. Ah. It fell apart at the plungers. We had a pretty good run going there. Let's do one more. One more. We don't have a problem. We can quit at any time. We're in full control. This isn't like Putt-Putt where you literally cannot stop. Okay, good. Uh-oh, okay. We're going without. Okay, we're armed. Armed and dangerous. Last one. This is actually the last one because I have to probably go check on the dogs. So it works out. Yeah, the fun stops. Stop. Okay, looking good. I gotta give it to myself. I had a pretty good PB here. I don't know if I ever submitted this one, now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, caught on that edge, kind of weird. This is up to the left. Okay, good. By left, I mean right, of course. My directions are impeccable every time. There's nothing to worry about here. We do have one that will come there. Bear. Full clearance. Another one down here, right?
What?
Oh, that's too bad. Otherwise, that was pretty good. Oh, are you kidding me? Get there. Got by the plungers once again. Sheesh. Oh, well, it was a good session of runs here. I'm not upset with this. Well above average. I kind of got nice and close in this last little section up here. I'm not upset about it. It's all good. I'm gonna open up the full game here just so we can listen to the soundtrack for a sec, because it is very good. Oh, it's just gonna give us the beach first. So this is the full, the full game, obviously. Let's see kind of where, what we're working here. It's teaching us some things. But the map is much bigger. So this is kind of like teaching you that little tactic there to get over things. More beach. All right, never mind. Anyways, look up the soundtrack. It's absurdly good. It's really, really good. All right, people, let me pull this up again. We'll get out of Puggsy and we will spin the wheel again. And you should see the wheel here. Here we go. Well, shouldn't have closed out of that, I guess. This happens every once in a while, I suppose. Real quick, I'll get up here really fast. Well, we'll play a little bit more then. I suppose that's how random and strange. I guess. Pugsy is, it's just, it must be. It has been chosen. It has been chosen. Okay. I'm just going to take a quick BRB here just to check on the dogs. One sec, I'll be right back. Leave you with the excellent Puggsy soundtrack. 2 seconds. Let's do it again, people. The Puggsy must continue. I wonder if we'll manage to get a PB then, for sure. Try to get the launch there. Big boost on that one. Love it. Nice. I gotta remember to grab that thing. Cause now we're in a pickle here. What does this do? We'll never know. Oh, do we get sunglasses? What does that mean? What do sunglasses do? Oh, we get a free hit. Oh, okay. Sunglasses are cool. I need to make a Puggsy emote with the sunglasses. Something to rival George Stobart, cool. Pace, on pace. Good. This is what we wanted. Okay. Okay, here we go. This is actually like the sneaky hard level, I think. The candle one is like hard for a different reason, you know? But there's like no bad guys here, so... Like this is a level that's pretty doable, like if you just kind of get your mechanics down. Which we're getting better at. Oh, no. What? That's the voice, like the noise of Puggsy. There it is, okay. I'm really getting bugged out by the plungers here. I think you should remove it from the wheel as soon as you hit it. We could consider doing that, especially with the new rules in place. We could definitely do that. I'm gonna do one more run, and then we will continue to spin here. Personally, I don't mind playing a little bit more Puggsy because it's just a fun game. Don't mind a little bit of Sega weirdness in my life. Ooh, that was smooth, huh? Totally intentional. Okay, we're within 2 seconds at least right now, so... Oh, wow. Got away with one there. Let's go. Yeah, I don't know what to do about that one. I must have let go of down. Like a very inopportune time. Rough. Rough stuff here. No, trying to go for some swag strats here and see if we can maybe, like, you know, flick it. Look at that. First time every time, right? Let's see if at least get a quick kill here. We did not. Brutal. Okay. That works for me. Puggsy. Good old Puggsy. A good time had by all. And that one was already marked, so let's get it back and spin in here now. Look at the big baby. Ooh, Frog Detective 2, let's go. Alright, so we did a first play of this a little while ago. Very, very fun. Frog Detective rules. Looking forward to my Frog Detective 3 playthrough at some point soon. But for now, we are going to enjoy a little bit of Frog Detective 2. The Case of the Invisible Wizard. So I've not done a speed run of this particular game. We did the casual play you're curious about that one. Is it FP VODs? It's FP VODs. It's always the one I do second. If you're interested in watching that playthrough, the playlist, it's a single session, is there. You don't want to spoil anything. We are definitely going to play through the game now. Where is the video game? Frog Detective. Frog Detective. We're gonna have to make new splits for this, actually. And we're gonna have to figure out how we're gonna capture this. Oh, just like that. That works. So I guess in the beginning, we won't make any splits. We'll just do beat the game. Beat the game. Frog. Frog. Case 2. So I have some runs of case 1. I think I may have broken to the top 10 on that board. That was a fun one. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay. We'll leave it here for now. Okay. Bam. Let me pull up the SRC page, because it's my understanding that this game has some high-quality notes. From Archie. Would be terrific to have. When I can bring Chad up to a better spot here as well. There we go. Wow, absurd ad on SRC. Okay, where are you, Frog? Good soundtracks today, I will say that. All right, this is from 4 years ago, so hopefully it's, you know, there's no new tech we'll be missing or anything. Looks pretty straightforward. All right. We can hear, we can see. Boy, this is gonna be a problem though. There's some sort of ad right now on speedrun.com that is like literally completely breaking all of the formatting on this page. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna take these lovely notes. And I'm just going to port them over. To a notepad. That way I can get rid of this absolute chaos happening over here. Very good. Okay. Sweet. I think these are pretty quick. You can see world records are on 15 minutes. So we might be able to squeeze a couple of these in depending on how quickly we get Oh, the other thing I should have checked is when time begins and ends. I do believe that, oh, here we go. Timing starts when losing control in the main menu upon starting a new game. I guess that's clicking play. Timing ends when the final phone call ends. No key rebinds, auto hotkey scripts, or similar tools. Fair enough. Perfect. Okay. All right. The stakes have been set here. Any options that will help us? We'll probably want to change the sensitivity a little bit, but we'll do a run first. What do we have going on here? Oh, Raiders! PMC! Welcome in. This is a great reminder that I need to get rid of this very odd raid note that happens here where it just says somebody's name. There we go. Welcome in, PMC and Raiders. Very nice to have you all here. Yeah, we're about to embark on an adventure of the Frog Detective 2 variety here. This has been hit on our wheel of speedruns. I've done a casual play of this game and it rules. But yeah, I've never once done the speedrun, so we're about to jump into it. Thank you very much for the raid. I hope you had a lovely stream, and welcome in, people. Nice to have you here. But yeah, I've had this like a bot thing where I've been trying to auto shout out people. Like, my goal is to try to do this. What is it? Shout out EMC trilogy, right? This here, this thing where it's like, join us in following this thing. I would love for that to be automatic so I didn't have to like hand type it out, because sometimes, you know, you're in the middle of a speedrun or something, you're in the middle of something and you don't want to have to be like, okay, let me hand, like, you know, time is of the essence, right, in a speedrun. So I was trying to make a bot just do that, but it has not played nicely, and I think the end of this whole thing has basically just boiled down to the bot just repeating whoever's name it was, and that's where it ends. So it's just kind of it's actually kind of funny and charming, but it's also a little bit unnerving, where it's kind of like, why did he do that? Zector. Oh, very good. 5 out of 5 game. I'll have to watch the VOD back. I've been enjoying that series very much. For those that don't know, PMC's playing through, like, it seems like every PlayStation game. I don't know if there's any more nuance to it, but it's been a very fun series to watch so far. Yeah, ellipses. It just kind of, like, is very dramatic. Yeah, sort of like if somebody's like has their back to the thing and they kind of like spin around, they're like, EMC. Stroking a cat or something. But we have a treat redemption. Let me see if they're interested in coming out here. They're snoozing at the moment. Promise we'll get to the run here in a sec. But we have a lovely redemption here from Galaxy to give my dogs some treats. So I think good, yeah. It's just a very awkward freeze frame of me. Very good. Oh, we're having a day here on stream. This is very good. Let me quickly fix my camera, because that's what's up. So this is going to look weird for a moment. Bear with me, people. This is some big-time pro streamer action happening. You don't even know what's going on. Here we go. Here we go. Dog? Dog. There we go. Very good. So this is Bonnie. And here's a treat for Bonnie. There we go. So we are dog sitting for our friend's dog as well. Toby's not used to this sort of setup here. So I wonder if we can make this work, because Toby is in a bit of an awkward spot, and I think he's a little bit of afraid of the camera because he doesn't really know what's going on. Would you like a treat, Toby? See if I can get the camera going. There he is. There you go. You want a treat? I'm down here for you. There he is. He's a little unsure about what's going on in here. As our friend's dog, Toby. And like Bonnie's best friend. The two of them are two peas in a pod.
Good job. Yeah.
Let's get one more shot of the bonbon here. So we always traditionally get a little bit of scritchy scritches going here as well. Bonnie, of course, very natural in front of the camera, perhaps too natural. There's times where I'm just sitting in here and she'll kind of be like, where are my treats? You're sitting at the computer. This is where the people give me the treats. But yeah, two of them have been snoozing in the other room. They've been playing and stuff. So they were doing that whole thing. Anyways, thank you very much, Galaxy, for the redemption. Very much appreciated. Wholesome doggo content here before we solve the case of the invisible wizard. Oh, that would actually be hilarious, Archie. Just do the whole command, but with a raid. That's an excellent idea. I might take that. That's very funny. Such a specific joke. All right, let's do it. Brave Toby, yeah. Very shy Toby in this case. Is this capturing everything? Yeah, we're good. Okay, cool. Let's see what happens starting now. Or not. Oh, wait, hang on. We still have Puggsy controls going on here. Let's get rid of this, Sega Genesis nonsense. Yep. Here we go. I think, was it F? That's to like skip text or something like that. There's a button I think that speeds it up from the first one. Oh yeah, F. Look at this. Just big ups to every dev that like looks out for the speedrunners out there. It's the lobster, right? Yeah. The show. Game is so good. Do I have two instances of five split open right now? No. Okay, go, go, go. Oh, wait, that's right. I have to go back along the hallway here. A little strafing. Good book. I guess we left it as we saved our old notebook, which did rule, to be fair. Hey, Summer. Welcome. So that's probably worthy of a split there. It's like, leave the office. This is how you travel here. Jeez, it sounds like a mess, Summer. I'm sorry to hear that. Holy moly. Well, hopefully, Warlock Woods here will, sweep you away. Susan. Okay, so I'm taking a look at the notes here. So Mandy, we gotta get some pies, and in the pies. Okay. Let's see what happens here. Police and ambulance. Yeah. London, baby. Okay. Is this Mandy? Are you Mandy? I should have, not Susan. That's alright. This first run, I gotta remember everybody's names. We gotta talk to Susan eventually, don't we, anyway? Yeah, we do. All good. Mandy, you're Mandy, yes? You got pie things, yeah. Your top option about the pies. Okay, so then we want to pick up the pies, it appears. Okay. All right, so the first pie we want to get is here. I wonder if there's, just trying to get this thing moving here, by Naughty. Are you Naughty? I think it must be. Flower Pot by Singer. Oh no, this is Pie by Hot Tub. Okay, so that's the last one we actually want to get. So we got the first one. That's the next pie then. Maybe. Dog Mayor on the platform. Yeah, I think this is good. I gotta remember this whole thing again. Oh, here we go. Pie there. Okay. So yeah, I guess the play would be to go... So we get the entrance one, the one in the flower pot. Well, I guess... Yeah, we kind of just juke our way through, because then we have this one as well. And then the one by the hot tub we already have. Flower pot. I think we have everything. Yeah, we hit Puggsy twice, which was kind of funny. I think we're good. There you go. Give item pies. I gotta find Victor. Victor. Carlos is the shop person, I believe. Tub, oh, beautiful. nightmarish vibes. It's an interesting game, for sure. Okay, wizard. And we want to go pie here. Oh, we got one money. We got the money. So we had to go through all of these bits here. Such a rude individual. Maybe just rude in general. Yeah, okay, I remember Carlos. Yeah, Puggsy is like it's a platformer game, but there are items that you use. So there's a little bit of like kind of puzzle solving, like item-based puzzle solving. But it's like also a platformer, and then it also has like some physics puzzles as well. It's kind of all over the place, and you play as this giant like, I mean, is Puggsy a triangle alien thing? Kind of looks like a party hat, speaking of having a party hat briefly there. Like a party hat with antenna or something. Oop. There we go. It's a very weird game. Good soundtrack. Okay, then we go back to Naughty. Ralph, Mary, Susan. I feel like I knew that there were, where are you? You're Mary. I don't have enough money yet. We get like blackmailed here or something, I'm pretty sure. It's like some very funny circumstance with Mary. Is extorting me. That's it. Hello? This is who we wanted to talk to. Wizard. And then we should get an option about a rug. Oh, that's a pretty good shout there. Oddworld. I haven't thought about Oddworld and those games in a hot minute. Abe's Adventure, whatever. The mayor. Okay, Ralph, you better be. I say this guy better be Ralph. Pretty much the last character. Okay, so I think we've got all of our money now. And a hook. I wonder why we want to do Mary before Susan. I guess it's closer to the house. We must get the details that we need from her at the end. Yeah, okay, we're good. thinks I am small, I am not. So we gotta cut through here. Okay, let's get rid of our extortion here. Despite how thrilling it is. Hey, Swan. Tank controls. Oh, really? It's a game that I've never played, I don't think. I think I had a friend that had one of those games, because there are a bunch of Oddworld games, if I recall correctly. That sounds... Tank control is just... I don't know, it's tough. You can get, like, you can get used to it. Like, I think of, like, Grim Fandango and, like, even, like, kind of the early days playing through, Escape from Monkey Island, it was, like, rough, but... Okay, we can't go in yet, I guess. Oh, we need the glasses, right? Oh, we gotta use the phone, of course. Mysterious number. I really like this guy's like little bobblehead Lua Dancer-esque like ornament on the desk. This is such a chill game. I love it. So we should be able to enter now. To save a minor amount of time, do not lie about evil guy. Okay, that's what the note says here. Oh, the little smoke animations. Can we not go in yet? What am I missing? Boom, boom. Oh, the glass. Of course, the glasses. Okay. The next run, I think, will be a little bit smoother now that we've kind of gone through, gone through the motions here. My sensitivity feels good. I was curious if I would go crazy or not with that. But it feels fine. I love just the pies everywhere. I detected many frogs yet? Absolutely. We're deep in the detective game at this point. oops. Just gonna try and check the when the phone call ends. Knowing when to call the time here. Do not lie about evil guy. So second answer. I think that's what we did on our casual playthrough as well. We told the truth. Like it's really struggling. I don't know why, but I'm just jamming out with the music here. I may change, I may change my settings down a little bit lower. I think we're at like the absolute best. A little bit later. I think we have a phone call here, right? Is that time? I think that's time. Let's see here. Oh, do we have another phone call? Cliffhanger, huh? Yeah, that must be. So we must have been had time maybe like a minute ago. This is just a big teaser for the big finale here. Is when that phone call ends. Okay, cool. Epic double music here. Yeah, we gotta play Fraud Detective 3 at some point. We gotta. We must. We must know how it concludes. Okay, let me really quick. I'm just going to switch this down. I think it was around 1941, I think, is what I saw for that. 2850. All right, I'll take your word at it. I'm hoping that we're going to beat this thing on this next shot here. Fastest. Oh, yeah. Why didn't we pick fastest right away? Wow. Alright, hopefully this will help us a little bit. Language, sure, English works. Now it's time to really go. We're gonna cook now. Let Woofs cook. Play a new game. Oh, one thing I will do. Actually, I'm gonna make one extra split here. And this is leave the office. Blame. Is it Lucy? Perfect. Here we go. Yeah, always got to go fastest. Predates F by 2. Well, that'll, yeah. F is like super powered. Hello, lobster cop. Boom, boom. I love how long this hallway is in this cutscene. It's very funny. The door just shuts. Oh, it's so good. Great. Notebook is already prepped. Look at that spin. Get there, get there, get there. Okay, that's some splitting there for leaving the office. I think this is just a big old cutscene. Through the spooky woods here. I like that the wheels just keep spinning there. Some of the funny little things. Lobster cop always just constantly runs in slow motion. After seeing how this is running right now, I really might get a new CPU or something. I did not build this computer with the intention of streaming, and here I am, many years later, streaming all the time. Should have known. Hey, Grubby, good morning. That's the kicker. Yeah. Yeah. I bought, so I built this computer in, I can't. Oh, we can pick up the pies now. Oh, crud. Should have gotten the other one. That's fine. I was just going to say there's pie over there. Got your pies. And we need more pies. Yeah. Yeah, this is a very... This was perfect for what I needed it for, which is... To run adventure games and, like, some basic stuff that I wanted to play. But the thing that I didn't expect to start doing after I bought the, or after I made the computer, built the computer, whatever it was to stream. And yeah, now that plus like stream plus the other things has proven to be pretty tricky. But yeah, I'll have to put some money aside. I think it'd be well worth it. Okay. Pie here, please. So we're still a little bit kind of being a little loosey-goosey with how this goes, but this is okay. I'm pretty sure that that first pie didn't appear until after we talked to Mandy, so I think we do need to take this first. It was kind of nice to grab one a little bit early. Alright, one money and a fresh pie. That's stamped in there. Confirmation that they're a good baker. So from here, we're gonna go to Carlos. Every time I'm ready to start turning around, because I'm used to Prog Detective 1, I have to make sure I go through the notebook stuff first. Could buy so many pies, that's very true. We have to deal with our extortion, though. This is the key thing. We will soon be extorted, as it will be thrilling. We have to save our monies. Okay, after this is Naughty, and then Ralph. Oh, more money. I gotta click there. I get so sucked into like the just the vibe of this game, of how like fun and goofy it is, that I like, it's very easy for me to forget like I have to do a click there, because I'm just like grooving to the music, or like kind of like looking around at the animations and stuff. They're so nice. All right, Wizard and Rug here. We go to Ralph, the lion. Got one money. I got no money. We got four money. Needs a rug. Long Snoot. Shouts out to the Long Snoot gang out there. Boom, 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 boom. This is how you detect, by the way. We are detecting at high velocity. Very good. Very good. Mary. Right. Oh, that's 5 money. That's all the money. I like that they're frog detective bucks. I like that frog detective gets no respect throughout the game, right? Everybody loves lobster cop. But there are frogs on those bills, my friends. Shouts out to the frogs among us. This is wizard for sure, right? No. We wanted to go knight. That's okay. Knight, and then we'll be extorted. Which we want. This is a friendly extortion. In a way that only this game could do. Five money done. Okay, last little bit here. Susan, this one we ask about the wizard. And then we should have an option to give her the hook. Which we got a little bit earlier on here. Beautiful. His notes are really good. That's very good. Let's make a phone call here. To the mysterious number. Very enlightening. Cool guy. Did I say Lucy? It's probably Lola. I don't know. Whatever. Makes it sound cool. Okay, I think we have access now to the end game. This actually might be a good another good split spot if I really want to get ticky tacky. Like enter the house here. It's here, right? I thought this was the case. You can click on the wizard from a little bit further away. And I was doing it on the last run, at least. A frog. Okay, this is pretty much the end here. I feel like we've been at a pretty good pace. Lola did it. I said Lucy. I don't know why I wrote Lucy down. Maybe we had Lucy dreaming on the brain. Blame Lola. We get a party either way. At the expense of my camera. The frame rate's dying, but we're having a great time. I just don't know how anybody cannot like this game. It's so, like, goofy and fun. I don't know. It's just adorable. It's a great game. Got one more thing to do. We have a phone call, telephone call to take here, to which I hope I will be quick enough to answer here. Waiting for the ring. Guess we got it. Okay, so when this phone call is over, that is time. I guess that's it. 1634 and a half seconds. I'll take that. I'll take that for kind of like the first real pass. I think that was pretty good. I have no idea where that puts me on the, oh, I can't look it up either. I'll look it up on my phone. We'll have a look. Fourth place. What? Oh my goodness. That's pretty good then. I'm very pleased with that. The pro leagues. Those are real names there. Let's go. Yeah, those are three names that I don't think I ever passed on Frog Detective 1 either. I remember Kenzie was talking on stream probably back when I was doing Frog Detective 1, and I think he'd mentioned that there's like some other optimizations and stuff to look at, and I had never gotten around to them. Maybe someday I'll look into that. Man, sub 16 is real. Holy moly. Like, I know mine wasn't perfect. I could see maybe shaving off, like, maybe, like, 20 seconds or so. You know, with, like, cleaning up my, my routing a little bit. Because we're bumbling around a little bit. But boy, those are wild times. Shouts out to them. Wow. Okay, cool. Well, hey, that was fun. 1634 PB. Put that one up on the wheel. I need to go through my archives a little bit and submit some runs, because I realize I don't think I have a Puggsy run up. I've done them before, but I've never submitted it. This is a new one. We gotta stick that one up on there. It's possible I haven't submitted like my newest KGB run. I never put up my Gabe 2 run. I've got a whole bunch of things that are like on my list, but I haven't gotten around to them, so. A good problem to have. Like having many things to work on up here. Okay. Music. Is music coming up? Who knows? It's not. What's going on here? Can I bring you here? Yeah, interesting. My stream deck just died. Very good. You love to see that. Love to see that. Is this better? But my computer is just having a moment right now. I didn't realize that. There we go. Frog Detective 2, putting my machine through the ringer here. I didn't expect that. Count. The KGB one is an old one. Okay. I thought so. The last run I had was pretty good for me, at least for my very, like, simple standards. But so I was curious. It's like, I think that one's on the list there, too. You know what was disappointing? For anybody, I don't know if anybody cares, but recently I did that Kessel Run event with Spade and Shocker and BMAC, and I was convinced internally that I had at least done a PB on like a single mission PB, because as I kind of like went further along in that light green lightsaber run, I was going from very slow to what I thought was very fast. I was cruising through those last couple of missions. Turns out that wasn't the case. I went and I retimed every single one of them. And no, they weren't fast at all. It's so funny how that works. I don't know, you're kind of in the heat of the moment, I guess. Think you're going quick. Alas. But that's actually another one. I do have a green lightsaber time now, so I'll have to submit that. But I was like, for sure I beat 14 and changed. For sure. I must have gotten under 10 minutes. Like, my closest one to it was like 20. I got like one 20-minute run out of that, and I was like, you know? It's the way she goes. Go bad for Auth. Times are so crazed. Yeah, you have to kind of like nickel and dime it, because it's just so much better. Yeah. Yeah, the times are insane. That's a 15-20. I just happen to have my splits still up here. 15-20. I know the Frog Detective 1 time is bonkers as well, because there was a moment where I was doing a bunch of, maybe it was just on the wheel, but I was doing a bunch of Frog Detective 1 runs, being like, I'm gonna get good at this. And I think I managed to get myself into like 7th or something. And I was very pleased with my times, and there was like, we weren't even like within a minute, I think, of the top like time. It's insane. Really, really cool. Time for a new computer fund, maybe. I'm kind of going back and forth on that. Like, I could just build a brand new computer. I could do it. I don't have the money, but I could begin the fundraising, put stuff aside to do it. I built this computer right before COVID. It was like the most amazing thing I ever like decided to do. I was like, I need a new computer. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna build a new one. like, I had set some money aside and was just like, I'm just gonna do it. And so it was like an impulse thing. I'm like, I've told myself I'm gonna do it for a while. Let's just do it. And I did it. And then COVID happened. And I was like, well, I'm glad I have this machine now, because like, I'm going to be spending an absurd amount of time playing video games now, because like, the world is in turmoil. So that had happened, but that was obviously 4 years ago, I guess now. It wasn't really until this past, probably the last 6 months, that my CPU has really shown its age. So part of me is like, maybe I just replace some of this stuff. And then part of me is like, maybe I just get a whole new one, and I could give this one to Meows. Meows needs a new machine as well. And this is plenty good. I really don't have any problems with this machine. Other than I didn't build it to stream, and I didn't intend to start streaming ever. And then I started streaming, and now I'm streaming all the time. I can't get enough of it. It's like some sick disease that I have. So, yeah, it's perhaps not fit for purpose anymore. It's kind of an interesting one. It's 19th, and you're going fast. Yeah. That is like, it's one of those things where, this is another example of this. When I was playing Putt-Putt on this channel, Putt-Putt Saves the Zoo, people might remember that stream. I was really trying, like, I was trying hard, and I finally got that 76 second run, and I was thrilled, and that got me, like, 97th place on the board, and I was like, first page, like, let's go. I'm still stoked about it, but like, yeah, there are some, like, absolutely real speedrunners out there, like, it's crazy. Shouts out to them. What CPU do I have? I have an i5-9400F, which was plenty good to run what I was running on it. It starts to cook when we start doing things like encoding streams and stuff. Already feels dated from 2021, yeah. Yeah, I think we talked about this. Summer mentioned this earlier about my Colossal Cave run and how, like, it randomly went very fast after this, like, absurd update that they did. But I remember talking about it at the time and mentioning that my CPU was, like, extremely hot. It was running way too high. And that was, like, kind of, it felt like a bottleneck, I think, so. Craziness. Did I do well? You're unfortunately in the large pool of people we don't look at. Enjoy your leaderboard spot. Yeah. That is heartbreaking. I don't even know. I just, like, once I realized how competitive Putt-Putt was, and I kind of expected it because it's so short as well, like, it's like, you know, you're not talking about minutes of difference. It's like, this is, it's a do or die, like, every breath in that particular run. So I was like, if I get in the first page, I'll be pretty stoked, but... Oh, that's a good point, Soul Driver. I could run a 2-PC setup as well. That would actually be nice. I mean, that would have helped with this Disco Elysium thing, because I think by itself it probably would have been okay. It's like adding the encoding portion to everything is like... We're just doing everything on one machine, which is a bit much. Do we have any grub time for today? No? Okay, cool. Alright, with that in mind, I do need to get running pretty soon. As I think I'm going to be closing up shortly, I think I will do the old, tried and true thing here. Because I don't have enough time to really start anything, huge, with the time that we have. But I do want to play some more video game. Is anybody down for some Yoda story? Forget how absurdly loud this game is. Sorry about that. That should have been a really smooth transition, but instead, you probably can't even hear what I'm saying because you're deafened from the noise that just occurred. Just really quick saving my splits here for Frog Detective. Oop, there we go. Cool. Yeah, I did not beat this 1426, sadly. At my at that event, but I did have a good time. And yeah, Electric Dragon, you're 100% right. I got super unlucky. For anybody who didn't watch it, it's basically like my first map. So the category was Green Lightsaber, which is 5 nonstop missions back to back. That which actually reminds me, I should check and make sure I restarted this. I think we did. We have a blue lightsaber, right? Yeah, we're good. We're good. So I basically load up a map, my very first map, and I get to the very, very, very end of it. And I don't know if it was me or if it was the game. It's more likely me than anything else. But I'm not letting the game go scot-free completely. But I could not solve the end, like the very, very last puzzle of it, basically. And I burnt a ton of time trying to do it. So then I had to end up restarting all of it again and basically doing like, instead, I basically did 6 missions instead of just 5. And it was absolutely brutal. It was absolutely brutal. But all right, mind your ears here. Some old Dell R630s. I mean, if they find their way, if those particular things find their way in a skip near me, they may find their way into the wolf den here. That's actually really funny to think about. All right, let's do it. Oh, hang on. Sorry, we gotta do it one more time here. And go. Oh, there he is. Okay. That's the hardest thing to do is find out where this guy is. Navi computer and actually didn't see what level we had. Oh. Okay. This is the Clone War one, I think. Can we please leave? Ewoks. Okay. I think we just start from here. I've actually never done this mission. I've seen other people do it, but... this is the locator here, I think. Oof. Okay. What do you... oh, you need something, right? Excuse me. What do you need? Just a valuable. Hopefully it's not a Navi computer, otherwise this would be a little bit weird, but... electroscope. You know what? I will check and see if this guy wants an electroscope. I'll check that real quick. Electroscope. Yeah, okay, cool. I'm glad I checked. Mm-hmm. What do you want? A Navi computer? Yeah. I got that. So what? I was gonna say, do I get something? Yeah, droid part. Okay, we'll grab the two bottoms areas here. If I can. Okay. Must have to go up. Okay. What do you need? Requires a tool. I don't know if a droid part counts as a tool. Okay. Press onwards. Yes, boxes. Oh, first try. Condenser unit. Let's go. That's very nice to see. Such a weird puzzle, this one. To get the force. You have to like run into the plants there, like the little bushes, and they turn into turn into trees. A key card slot. Okay, we definitely don't have a key card to do that quite yet. What do you have in here? Let's use. Okay, key card. Wow. This has been very fortunate in terms of kind of the ordering. Snake can shove it. Why did it have to be snakes? Thought I was playing Star Wars today. Okay. Speed this way to the end. Alright, what do you need? What is happening here? Requires a vocabulator. I don't know. I have a droid part. Is that okay? Like perhaps a vocabulator would be okay, or like a this droid part happened to be a vocabulator. No dice. Okay. So that's our first, bad luck sort of deal here. That's okay. That's okay. Okay, off we go again. What else? Okay, so we have that top section up there still. Sort of figure out. Okay, we can take that bottom path as well when we come back. We'll do that again. This is a thing. What are you? Sonic cleaver. Sonic boom. Okay, so there's a thing in here somewhere. A droid detector. Okay. Droid detector. So what's... This is actually kind of rough. It's a, Like, we've got two or three travel spots, which is pretty bad luck because those are a little bit slower than the other possibilities. Okay, so this is the end area. So we'll return back to that. Okay, which means we need to go to the bottom there. The Sonic Cleaver, the condenser unit, must be what we needed to actually get, I guess. Who knew, right? Oh my goodness, get out of my way. Was it this? That's right, we gotta give... I'm assuming we give... something. Sonic Cleaver, pretty nice. Wait, did you not? I was gonna say, if that literally did nothing, I would, I might cry. I might cry on stream. Wouldn't make any sense. Okay, how do we get in here? Oh, is it here? Yes. What do you want? A condenser unit, and you give me a vocabulator. Okay. We have a path to the end now, which is good. It's possible, it's unlikely, but it's possible that we might be able to, PB. Within the realm of possibility. I have no idea what this endgame is going to look like, though. This is the scary part, I think. Yeah, so we gotta go this way. Keep an eye on our health as well here, because our health is in better days. We haven't gotten a single anything, as far as that goes. A lot of annoying bad guys on this one as well. Okay. So we have the vocabulator now, which this person wants. Here you are, friend. An anti-grav generator. Okay, so we should be good to go to the end now, which we know is going to be in that, like, top middle spot. Health, yes, please. I'll take the mushroom. Badger, mushroom. As it was foretold. Okay. Stay slow and low here. Like a good stew. We shoot up to the top without dying, I hope. That actually was another mushroom in there, but I don't think I'm going to double back for it. Good. South twice, and then we begin. We've got about 3 minutes on the clock to do the end game. Okay, this is the maze one. Oh, I want a Yubnut. Okay, Yubnut. I get you a Yubnut, kid. Don't you worry about that. I think. You want Yubnut? Where is Yubnut? Show me Yubnut. There are no Yubnut trees here. I must have to leave. Oh, there it is. Okay, I see it. Oh, it didn't drop it. Come on. Excuse me. Give me a Yubnut. Goodness. Okay, that's stinks. We'll see how that goes. Yubnut. New anti-grav unit. Thank you. Thank you. 2 minutes left. Oh no. Am I about to run back this absolutely horrible puzzle that I was stuck on the event? Because if that's the case, this could be quite bad for us. We must face our fears, I suppose. Turret's locked up tight. Okay, we're in. Going down. Okay, now it's a different one. It's not a great one, but, okay. We have to find the right guy here. I don't know if this guy's always in the same place each time. I wonder if he is. So far, it kind of appears that that's the case. Well, no, it is different. 111. Okay. I'm gonna go hide here to health. Okay, we're actually really fortunate to get that. I think it's this one? Yes, okay. 111. I forget what this does, but we did it. What's the puzzle here? Oh, okay, I remember. I think. So when we hit the button, I think we need to go up and out. And that should send off a whole bunch of bad guys here, I think. That should do this. Is it just this? Malfunction. Dread part. Excuse me. That was a tough go for us, I think, on that, because I think we were fortunate in the way that the trading went, but we were unlucky in how large that map was. And there was a few other setbacks. That was a tough one. It took me just like a split second too long. And by split second, I mean probably a minute too long to figure out the end game of that one again. Once you get the code, that unlocks the turret door outside. The turret door outside leads you to the end. Rough. But that was still pretty good. That's above average. I mean, that was faster than like my best by at least 5 minutes, I think, from the event a week or so ago. So, yeah, we'll take it. That's well above average. Very well.